The main goal of this video is to present the components and all the configurations required to track an FPV drone on a map in real time. There are many practical applications of this approach, but the most direct one is to spot in a visual way the area of a crash or the area of an emergency landing. So, let's start. As you can see, the drone's GPS position is sent to your phone through a crossfire telemetry connection and a Bluetooth link. But in order to do all of this, the TBS Crossfire TX module must be the full version 1 that embeds a Bluetooth component. You must also have the Telemetry Viewer app installed on your phone. This app is free and you can download it from the Google Play Store. Now, several configurations must be done at the level of the flight controller, crossfire receiver, crossfire transmitter, and smartphone. In what follows, I will present all of these steps. At this point, I assume that the TBS Crossfire receiver is correctly connected to a UART on the flight controller and also correctly configured inside the Betaflight. So, on the Betaflight configurator, make sure that the serial RX is enabled on the correct UART port. The receiver mode is set to serial base receiver, and the serial receive provider is set to TBS Crossfire. In the same mode, the GPS receiver is enabled and correctly configured. And most important, the telemetry output is enabled. The TBS Crossfire TX module and the receiver can be configured using the Lua script or by using the joystick and the display placed on the module. If you use the joystick and the display, press along the joystick. And here you have the devices. The transmitter, the first one, and the receiver, the second one. Go to receiver and ensure that the telemetry is set to on in the general tab. Now go back and on the transmitter and in the frequency section change the Bluetooth mode to Mavlink emulator. Another option is to configure the crossfire receiver and the transmitter from the station based on the Lua script. So, first long press the system button and go to the crossfire configuration. Here, select first the nano receiver, in my case. Wait for a moment. And ensure that the telemetry is set to on. Go back and select the crossfire transmitter and change the Bluetooth to Mavlink emulation. On your smartphone or tablet, turn on the Bluetooth and search for new Bluetooth devices. Now connect to the crossfire in the next step. Start the Telemetry Viewer application and connect to the TBS Crossfire TX module. Right now, all the configuration steps are done. and you will start to receive real-time telemetry data from your drone. An interesting fact. In the right part of the image, you have another flight. If the drone's GPS coordinates, the number of satellites, or the battery status in percent are correctly received and decoded, the data from the upper part is not every time decoded and displayed. But even in this case, you can quickly view your drone's position in real time without any problems. Now, enjoy the flight. So, this was all. Thank you very much for viewing this video and please subscribe and like it.